Oh, now was that in the text? Or did this get some background information here? Prior reading. All right, but it's still.
Teacher Jasmine Brown engages her students in the process of historical investigation, deepens their understanding of historical content, and develops their literacy. Jasmine's task is particularly challenging since Cesar Chavez Middle School is located in the urban area of Linwood, California, where students come into class with low levels of English literacy.
Teaching, you know, social studies is very challenging, and the kids have difficulty with reading and writing, but it's difficult to balance content and pedagogy.
Teachers like Jasmine have a big job for themselves. They not only have to teach history, but they have to teach literacy, they have to teach reading, writing, vocabulary, thinking skills.
But just like the slogan of her school's namesake, Cesar Chavez, Jasmine believes that yes, we can. Jasmine's challenge was met when she became involved with the California History Social Science Project.
The History Project has really helped me to reevaluate myself as a teacher. It challenged me. It challenged me a lot.
I've seen just a tremendous growth in her classroom instruction from when she started to where she is today. Also, she's a strong leader.
The History Project is dedicated to the pursuit of educational excellence in history and social science. It provides professional development and leadership opportunities for teachers to increase student learning and literacy. The History Project is part of the California Subject Matter Projects and is headquartered at the University of California at Davis. It is a unique K-16 collaborative of historians, teacher leaders, and scholars at six sites across the Golden State.
I think that the History Project helps teachers develop their knowledge of history. We have top-notch professors of history that have expertise in particular areas come and give lectures, share documents, and work with our teachers.
Stephen Aaron is one of those scholars whose role it is to provide content enrichment to teachers.
One of the things that I've certainly seen, and what I love about giving classroom or giving presentations to teachers, is the enthusiasm, the hunger that teachers bring. We try to help them see the connections between the scholarship and the standards. And then I think in the collaborative aspect of it, working with classroom teachers who are obviously far more able to then develop the lesson plans that can translate the scholarly content into usable information.
Jasmine and her students exemplify the History Project's work, just one of its success stories.
Everything that Jasmine does in the classroom is high level. She's always interested in getting students to wrestle with ideas at the highest levels of sophistication so that she's not just asking them to describe or regurgitate information, she's always asking them to apply information to a new context or to evaluate information.
I think what's helpful to me is the mentorship, being able to work with professors and to gain deeper understanding of history and being able to learn different strategies, you know, beyond just the basic, you know, mediocre instruction.
Executive Director Nancy McTighe became involved as a teacher and knows firsthand the power of the project.
History Project offers an opportunity for teachers to not only improve their craft within their own classroom, but share those talents with each other, engage in a camaraderie really that is quite powerful and keeps teachers in the classroom for a longer period of time engaged. And students, I think, as a result of that, are more engaged and excited about the discipline as well.
The impact on Jasmine's students is evident.
They are middle school students who are talking in deep, meaningful ways about the Constitution, the Bill of Rights, natural rights, these kinds of things that we would be very grateful to have most of the adult American public be knowledgeable about. We definitely see students improving in terms of their literacy skills, and those things are directly tied to things like the History Project's work.
Dr. Nancy Beer of SRI International has worked with the History Project for about a decade.
It's content-based. It's embedded in the subject, history. It's sustained over time. There's follow-up, either from a specific workshop or over years. It's differentiated for the teacher. So it's based on the teacher's previous knowledge and experience. It's contextualized so that it helps the teacher figure out how to take it back to their classroom if they have specific populations they're working with. So those are sort of four of the characteristics that the research world thinks is important and we have seen in the professional development from the History Social Science Project.
Dr. Baer says seeing the work the project does makes her research come to life.
There have been impacts on student achievement as measured by the California State Test of History Social Science and the State Test of English Language Arts.
The History Project has a proven past record of success and is constantly looking for opportunities to collaborate. It is an active member of the Library of Congress's Teaching with Primary Sources Consortium and has served as a partner with almost 50 Teaching American History grants. The California History Social Science Project, empowering teachers and their students.